If the Delta variant of COVID-19 is discovered in the community, health officials say we'll go straight back into an alert level 4 lockdown. It is a distinctly different approach to the one that has contributed to the size of the outbreak in New South Wales. Of course, the entire state is now under a stay-at-home order, more than 8 weeks after the Bondi cluster began, with more than 460 new cases yesterday alone. One News Australia correspondent, Andrew Macfarlane, has plotted what went so wrong.
Hello from Sydney, the COVID capital of Australia. It's been more than 50 days since large parts of New South Wales went into lockdown, and daily case numbers have now surged past 400, with officials warning they're not sure if we've reached the peak of this outbreak.
And very concerningly, we had 466 cases of community transmission. This is the largest jump we have seen in a night.
So, where did it all go wrong? On the 16th of June, an unvaccinated airport limo driver tests positive for the Delta variant, triggering a list of exposure sites in and around Bondi. In the following days, the driver's partner, along with those he had fleeting contact with, also catch the virus. The outbreak spills beyond Sydney's CBD, and New Zealand pauses the travel bubble nearly 1 week after the first case. The next day, with cases at 48, the state premier opts for a soft lockdown. Restrictions were tightened 3 days later, but numbers have continued to surge since.
The most important part was that they didn't do a hard enough lockdown early in the piece.
I'm speaking with Professor Tony Blakely, a leading epidemiologist who has been advising the New South Wales government.
The virus is now in the essential workers, in culturally and linguistically diverse communities. The virus has found the most likely place it can take hold in Sydney, and now it's very hard to eke out. So for those reasons, it's proving very challenging for Sydney. The chance of them actually getting back to zero transmission from here, I think, is unfortunately slight.
The one thing everyone seems to agree on, vaccines are Australia's best shot at bringing things under control. So, are they doing the trick? This is the number of locally acquired cases in Sydney, sorted by age over a 7-day period. The largest group testing positive, 10 to 29 years old, those who've had the toughest time accessing a jab.
I think it was right to vaccinate the vulnerable, and we did what we thought was right given the virus last year and early this year. But now we really have to ramp up the vaccination of who, whatever age they are, those people who are essential workers who have to stay out there when we've got lockdown.
OK, so Tony, what should New Zealand learn from this situation?
With Delta, New Zealand is much better just to shut themselves off until New Zealand gets its vaccine coverage north of 70%. And then you open up again. But the big learning out of this is how hard it is to control Delta if it gets a little bit out of control, so don't even let it get in.
That's something New Zealand's COVID response minister Chris Hipkins seems to agree with, signalling level 4 would most likely be used to crush any outbreak straight away, using any tool possible to avoid a Delta disaster like Sydney's.